name is Brian Cute. I'm the CEO of Public Interest Registry, and we're here in Dakar, Senegal, attending the ICANN meeting, promoting the introduction of .ngo, a new top-level domain for non-governmental organizations on the internet. For nearly 10 years, Public Interest Registry has been operating .org on the internet. We've been operating .org in a trusted and secure manner. And with over 9 million customers in .org, we feel we have a real connection with the not-for-profit and voluntary sector. In talking to them, we've learned that their biggest concern is that they don't want disreputable NGOs to come onto their space on the internet. They care very deeply about their reputation. They're very passionate about their missions. And they want only legitimate NGOs to be in a new top-level domain on the internet.
We don't really know who's who and who's doing what in Africa. I mean, people can hear said that they are NGOs. So creating this new extension might be a solution.
Who is doing a good job? Who is not a fake thing? It's a good opportunity to certify those communities and show them to the world and to be trusted.
So as long as NGOs understand that this is a TLD that represents them, and I guess .ngo has some sort of verification and authentication process in place, it will definitely hold them in good stead and give them that additional amount of credibility.
NGOs are by their nature very diffuse. The international community, there are millions and millions of NGOs on the web. Finding them, finding ones that are good, finding ones that you can believe in and you can trust and give money to and things like that, very, very difficult. And the idea of having an online destination which could be a community gathering point for NGOs, very strong idea in my opinion.
But it will be a great success in my opinion. It will rely on security and stability, and it will avoid fraud, for instance, when there is a natural disaster and people have to do some donations. I would trust it 100% rather doing it through a .ngo rather than through a .com, for instance.
So Public Interest Registry is here in Dakar, Senegal, at the ICANN meeting, engaging further with NGOs so we can better understand how we can provide the best possible TLD to promote their interests and their missions. And so we're going to be offering the .ngo and .ong for French-speaking and Latin-based speaking communities across the non-governmental organizational space.
Believability. Trust is the single most important currency in this field right now. And the kind of people who would run a .ngo needs to be like PIR. It needs to be somebody with a long track record in the field who has the faith and the trust of the NGO community themselves, and a group that has the background, that has the technical background to get the job done, someone that is known by the marketplace. The idea that someone would start from scratch on a project this big makes no sense.
Well, they've done a good job with .org, so I think they understand what it means to sort of cater to that niche and make sure that people out there understand what the TLD stands for, because they've been able to do that with .org. Slowly but surely, the message is getting out in terms of what that TLD stands for. So I think they should be able to manage that with .ngo.
I think it's a good fit. I think .org, PIR, has done a really good job in the past few years. Branding and positioning and explaining .org as a community-based, you know, nonprofits a part of it, type of extension that really differentiates itself from ComNet and, you know, other GTLDs. So I think their work there has been successful, and I think as a result, PIR is a good fit to manage a extension like .ngo.